Hi, I'm Ricardo. I work on the Google Play team. I'm going to tell you about all the tools available in the developer console to help you build high quality apps for Google Play, from tips in the publishing process to how to make the best of the data and reporting available to you. Let's start from the basics, targeting the right audience. First, it's a good idea to do a bit of market research and assess your target audience. Understand what Android versions and screen sizes you want to target. If you go to developer.android.com and search for dashboards, you can get relevant graphs to show you which versions you will want to support. You're likely to get the best results if you design your app to work on tablets from the start. The increased screen area on tablets gives you more possibilities and allows for more engagement with the user, which can mean increased usage as well as more monetization opportunities. If you're building a game, make sure you choose the right category among the 18 new game categories we recently added in Google Play. After sorting out the general outline and placement of your app, it's time to start building it. But don't wait until your app is 100% finished before showing it to people. We have designed beta testing to help you get user feedback as early as possible. Before your app is ready to be seen by the world, you can distribute it to a group of users you select. We call this alpha and beta test groups. If you don't yet have a production version of your app will be invisible in Google Play, except to the testers you choose. If you're using Google Play Game Services, you can use the alpha and beta testing to test your game services as well. You can use Google Groups or Google Plus Communities to indicate which users you want to be able to access the test versions of your app. You can set a What's New field for each version of your app, including the ones for testers. And this is really useful to tell your testers what's new in the alpha and beta versions they are about to receive. Each user will need to opt in to be a tester for each app and download the app, of course. To aid users in doing so, many developers create a little web page with a set of instructions that they send out to their testers or mention it in their group or Google Plus community. Now that your alpha and beta test is in progress, it's good to know that users who are alpha or beta testers cannot leave reviews for your app. In this way, you can protect against leaks about your secret app or harm to your ratings if your beta version still has some bugs. However, you can still see crash reports, optimization tips, and statistics in the developer console. And we explicitly mark out results that pertain to your alpha or beta test. So for example, you can quickly isolate all application crashes that your beta testers are experiencing. Your beta testers are great for identifying bugs and big usability problems, but keep in mind, they are not a representative sample of your target user population. Once your app is looking good to your beta testers, and it has been through a full round of testing on your side, it's time to publish. Once your app is published to all users, you will have some options when you roll out your next updates. Here at Google, we want to be sure that everything goes well when we roll out new version of our apps, and we know that you do as well. For this, we design stage rollouts. You can roll out updates of your app to just a percentage of your users, like 5%, and then crank it up to 100% when you can see that the reviews are still good and there are no problems on the horizon. Don't panic if you realize that you rolled out a bad version while a stage rollout is still in progress. Spin up a bug fix and publish a new version. Your fix will go out to the users who have the bad one and you can resume the rollout. Now that I covered the publishing process, let's focus on monitoring how your app is doing. Here at Google, we think that developers do best when they have lots of insights into their users and app performance. Most successful developers tell us that they log into the developer console every day to check on their statistics, reviews, and optimization tips. Here is an overview of some of the types of data that is offered in the developer console that we think more developers should be looking at. Starting from the basics, most of you know that you can see installs and uninstalls over time in the developer console. In addition to that, if you just go to the statistics page, you can see how your app ratings have changed over time, crash trends, and if you link your developer console account with Google Analytics, data about your active users and their engagement with your app. Be sure to click on app version to make sure you compare your new versions against the older ones. Also, use the CSV exports to download the full dataset beyond the first top 10 values. If you're a game developer and you use Google Play Game Services in your app, you can monitor your game performance and key player metrics using the new game stats module that we just launched a few weeks ago. Crashes can be a major problem. They make users unhappy and dissatisfied. They can result in bad reviews and users uninstalling your app in frustration. So we have spent time making the crash reporting feature in the developer console even better. You can check on your beta test and your stage rollout by filtering your crashes by version. You can also see how these crashes break down across different devices and Android versions to make it easier to track down what's going wrong or why users on a certain device are complaining. If you develop in native code, we have improved the reporting and presentation specifically for native crashes, with better clustering of similar crashes and summarizing of relevant information. Also, remember that we collect crashes in real time, so you can monitor your stage rollout or beta version minutes after publishing it. Finally, optimization tips show you new ways that you can improve, tailored to your own apps and users. From adding translations, making sure your app works well on tablets, and ensuring your app is using the latest versions of the Google services you integrate with. We also help you out with alerts, letting you know if there has been a big change in your installs, uninstalls, ratings, or crashes. With alerts, you can trust Google to alert you whenever a relevant event occurs, so you can focus on building your app. We just added the ability to get these alerts over email, so make sure you subscribe to this new service from the settings section of the developer console. To summarize, let me remind you the core aspects in building a quality app. Research and identify your target audience. Collect early feedback via beta testers while development is still in progress. Do risk-free releases with stage rollouts and keep optimizing your app with the data that Google Play makes available to you. Now get cracking.